Hi friends, let us understand why people lose money in stock market. It's a known fact that majority of people lose money in stock market. Even people who are really smart and quite successful in their professional career are not able to make money when it comes to their investments in shares. Therefore, before we move forward with this topic, it's really important that you understand why this happens with majority of people. Here are the most common reasons why most people lose money in stock market. Number one. Investing based on free tips and not doing your own research. This is the most common and the biggest mistake that people do when they start investing in the stock market. They easily trust free tips they hear from a friend, colleague or a financial magazine. Moreover, most people also blindly follow the recommendations from their stockbrokers, which later turns out to be a bad decision. Now you may argue, what's wrong with taking free tips and suggestions? Your friends or brokers may have more experience than you and surely can help you in getting higher returns. However, if you think like that, you are missing the point. No one else cares more about your money than you do, because it is your money at stake. You need to do your independent research too and not just blindly follow the free tips or recommendations. You can easily roll out the broker's recommendations, as there is always a conflict of interest between the brokers and their clients. Brokers will earn only when you trade. They will get their brokerage fee as long as you continuously buying or selling. They don't care whether you win or lose. Hence, they will always try to provide free suggestions or tips so that you can trade more frequently. But most of these free recommendations do not give good returns to the customers. Next, let us discuss investment decisions based on free suggestions from friends or colleagues. Regarding this, there are few things that every beginner should know. First, all your friends will always boast about the profits and high-performing stocks. But no one of them will tell you about their losing investments. It's mostly a matter of pride. From the outside, you may think that your friends or colleagues are always doing great with their investments, but actually they are not. You might take the suggestions thinking that they are quite experienced. However, in the end, you will end up losing your money. Hence, you may listen to your friends or colleagues, but never invest blindly based on such free suggestions. The only way to invest intelligently is by doing your own research. Reason number two, trying to make money fast, like really fast. Most people are always in a hurry to make money. They always want to become rich quickly, always want to become the next Warren Buffett. However, what they don't understand is that Mr. Warren Buffett, the most successful stock market investor of our time, has made the majority of his fortune after his 50s. He has accumulated a large fortune in his life only through his long-term investments for a period of over 5 decades. Success in stock market investing needs time and patience. But this is not how people think when they enter the stock market. They hear a stock's name on any random financial news channel, which comments like huge growth potential with 3 to 4 times returns within a year, and they invest heavily in it. Then they pray that price goes high. However, it turns out to be a loss of 30 to 40% of their investment. So out of frustration, they quit investing in stocks and start searching for another way that will make them rich quickly. This is how the non-achiever in stock market thinks and loses their money in the market. However, instead of picking highly risky stocks, if they would have chosen safer stocks like large cap companies with a history of consistent performance, they would have given them better returns. Number three, sudden overexposure to the market and non-diversification. This happens a lot many times in the stock market. A common man accumulates a good amount of savings from his job, then he hears how his neighbor or colleague has doubled his money by investing in stocks. Suddenly, he also gets interested in the same market. He starts thinking that if his neighbor, who is a salesman, can get so many returns from the stock market, then why can't he? Hence, he decides to enter the stock market without having any knowledge or experience with a huge amount of money that he has saved during all those years of his hard work. And this is where most beginners fail. The point is, you can enter the stock market whenever you want. However, entering the market without being prepared to it is totally stupid. Think of this like jumping in a lake without knowing how to swim. You need to learn the skills first. Similarly, you need to understand the market first and later enter once you are at least a little prepared. In addition, non-diversification is also one of the biggest mistakes that most people do. Putting all your saved money in just stock market investments and not diversifying can be very risky. No matter how much confidence you may feel, do not go all in, especially when you are just entering the market. Number 4. Holding on to losses while booking profits early. Let's imagine a scenario. You bought 5 shares. 3 of them are doing great while other 2 are underperforming. What will you do? Which shares will you sell first? The shares that are doing great or the ones that are not performing well? Sell the winners and hold the losing stocks. The majority of immature investors follow this rule. They believe that it's safe to sell the winning stocks first. That will give them the good profits and hold the losing stocks. In this way, the losing stocks will get more time to recover and they might bounce back to their initial investment price. Moreover, in the meantime, they will get some profits by selling their winning stocks. However, this is the wrong approach. By following this approach, you are limiting your upper profit level and increasing your lower downside level. It means that you are limiting how much profits you can make as you have already sold your winning stocks. But you can suffer even great losses as the losing stocks are still in your portfolio. If you want not to lose money in the stock market and make bigger returns, then you should follow the opposite approach. You should limit your lower level and maximize your upper level. Let the winning stocks give you even higher returns and cut the losses. Number 5. Lack of patience. This is another key reason why people lose money on stock market. Patience is the key success in the stock market. The only thing that you need to do while investing in the stock market is to buy good stocks and give it some time to perform. This is the right way to make money from your investments. However, most people who lose money in the stock market do not follow this approach as they do not have patience. Although many people are able to find good stocks, they aren't able to get good profits and they can't even give a few years of time they invested companies to grow. They want quick returns. Always remember that the stock price will never start to move higher when you initially purchase it. It is possible that the price goes down 10 to 15% in that month or next few months. However, you need to have patience in such situations. In most of the cases, when stocks lose 20 to 30% of their worth, people become highly impatient and sell their stock quickly. However, if you have just kept those stocks for a couple of more months, they could have got good returns of around 30 to 40% of their investments. Here, the lack of patience misfires on their intelligence of choosing a winning stock. Number 6. Blindly following the crowd. This is the last reason that should be mentioned here. Blindly following the crowd. It is also famously called herd mentality or herding. Imagine a scenario. Your neighbor bought a stock which increased its value by 30% in a few weeks. Then your colleague bought the same stock and the stock has now risen to around 40% appreciation from its initial value. Everyone is talking about the stock and it's making a lot of noise in the news. What will you do now? Everyone is getting good returns by investing in that stock. Won't you invest in the stock too? If you blindly follow the crowd and buy the same stock, then you are most likely to lose your money. In such scenarios, the early investors are mostly the ones who make money at the cost of later entrants. In many scenarios, it also results in bubble formation, which later bursts to results in everyone to lose money. Moreover, every intelligent investor has some plans and strategies for the investment. You just can't know the exit strategy of your neighbor by blindly following him. Maybe when you thought to buy, you was planning to sell the stock in a few days thinking it has overpriced. Never invest blindly following the crowd. Thank you, friends.